In this video, I'll be showing you how I added cooling fans to a LCD flat panel television set. Please keep in mind, if you plan on doing this yourself, that you will probably void your warranty if you still have one. With that out of the way, we'll go ahead and turn the TV on. Alright, nothing too fancy. But the special part about this TV is located on the back of the television. So let me go ahead and turn it around for you and I'll show you. Here we're looking at the back of the TV set. And we're looking at the fan controller panel. Made custom labels and everything. Here we got the on-off switch for the fans. We got your LED indicator light and adjustable fan speed. And I want to thank my friend Jamie for helping me out on this with some of the fabrication work. It was really hard to cut through that plastic. And here we have the port, which leads to the fans. Trying to put it back in. This is power to the fans, and there's four fans total inside the television set. And here it leads to a USB service port, which is mainly used for upgrading firmware for your TV and displaying photos off a thumbstick. But the cool thing about it is it's an easy power source. And see, it's just a regular USB, just like your computer. The cool thing about it, it outputs about 5 volts at about 500 milliamps maximum. I could be wrong, and I don't know. But this whole system runs off about 360 to 400 milliamps, so it's in perfect range, and it only consumes about 2 watts of power at full speed. And we'll go ahead and turn it on. Just flip, and I have this panel upside down. You know, nobody's perfect, but so on is downward, and you can see the LED indicator light turn on. And you can hear the fans fire up. And located at the bottom of the TV, bottom middle, are two fans situated inside the PCB cage for the main board, pretty much the main processing board for the whole TV set. So it's basically sucking cool air in from the bottom and blowing it inside the cage and out the top. And you can actually feel the air getting pushed out. And this runs pretty much cool all the time now. So we got two fans there, and located on this side at the very bottom, we drilled out some holes for two other fans, which suck in cool air from the bottom and blow it over the power supply board and out the top. And you can feel the warm air getting pushed out. All that ambient warm air kills electronics. But you're probably wondering why in the world would I want to do this. I don't know. I was bored. But it works. Will it extend the life of the TV? I don't know. Time will only tell. Okay, on this panel, you can adjust the fan speed. Not sure if you can hear the fans getting slower. And And then you want to do full blast again. It really depends. If it's too loud for you, you can turn it down a little bit. But it's perfectly fine when you're watching TV. You can't hear the fans at all. And this is totally optional. You don't have to have this. But if you want to extend the life of your TV, or theoretically extend the life of your TV, then go for it. But I wanted to find an inexpensive way, an unintrusive way, to add cooling fans to a TV without having to hack apart a power supply board and tap, you know, the 5 volts or whatever. I just don't feel like doing that. I don't know if it's possible or not. So yeah, this is a standalone system. Anybody can do it. And I'll go ahead and show you the inside.